seek God's blessings on each one of us, our family members. May God bless everyone of us, especially as we celebrate today the Independence Day, right? July 4th is the Independence Day of our United States. Pray for the country, pray for all the peoples that everywhere people might feel the peace of the Lord and the harmony between one another. This, let us begin this sacrifice of love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and failures. Prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Reading from the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, the
give praise to you, Lord, for all of you who do these things from the lives and the learning, and have been given to the believers. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious word. All things have been given to me by my God. Lord, Lord, the Son, except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to be revealed. Come to me, all you who made me, and I am the Lord, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon me, learn from me, for I am weak. And you will find rest for your sons. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Sisters and brothers in Christ Jesus, can you hear me properly because of the noise? Shall we turn it off? What do you say? Yeah? Can you hear me? Fine, thank you. There was an old story told about an old man who was very shabby, not looking so good. He used to visit the church in the noon, about 12 o'clock. And this habitual action of this particular old man was noticed by the sacristan. And seeing this old man, the sacristan came forward and said, "A man, I am seeing you every day here in the church. What are you doing here?" And then this old man said, "I come to pray here daily. But I don't see you daily praying and long enough to sit here in the church. And you come for a few minutes and you get away. What are you doing here?" And this sacristan was very much perplexed, because all things are very costly. Whether this old man would take away any of the things from the church. So he was very much careful. But then this old man said to the sacristan, "I come here, look at Jesus, and I just tell him, 'Hey Jesus, it's Jim here. And I'm sure and I believe he hears me. For 2 minutes I'm here and I am back home.'" After a few months, this old man meets with an accident and he is taken to hospital. And there, so this particular old man is very happy, making the whole hospital ward where he was admitted, making people, everybody happy. And then the nurse of that ward just asked him, "Jim, what's the secret of you that you are happy and you make others happy?" And then this old man said, "I can't but be happy is because my visitor makes me happy." Hey, come on, you are an old man, nobody knows about it, you don't have anyone to come to see you, and I have never seen anyone, but still you are saying that you have a visitor. How come? Then he says, "Yes, I have a visitor in the person of Jesus every day at 12 o'clock in the noon. And he just comes and stands at my bed. I look at him, he smiles at me, and he gives me that happiness. I am happy because my visitor makes me happy." Yes, my dear sisters and brothers, today the gospel brings a message to us the same. Come to me, all those who are heavily burdened. I will give you rest. My yoke is easy, my burden light. When this particular old man who was feeling heavy of himself and he wanted to find rest in God, that is why every day at noon he visited him, poured out his own heaviness, his own hardness of his heart, and he was finding rest. When he was bedridden, when he was taken to hospital, and same Jesus wants to give him even in his own struggling time. Today, I'm pretty sure that all of us have the same burdens. Sometimes heavy, sometimes a bit light. But all of us are filled with one or the other burdens in our life. The family people are the head of the person. The father or mother would be feeling that the responsibility of the family life or taking of the family upon themselves would be burdensome. How can we raise the children? How can we find a better future for our children? And that could be a burden for them. And for those people who are taking care of the elderly parents, for them the parents, the sickly parents may be burdensome. For those kids who are studying, if the subjects are harder, for them studying is burdensome. For those people who are working in their own workplaces, if anything finds or anything comes harder, or if they find something strange, they feel it burdensome. So life is full of burdens. And it is for those people Jesus calls, come to me. Never be wearied out. Never be burdensome. I will give you rest. How soothing it is. How consoling it is that a person is calling us to take a rest in himself. It's like there was a family, husband and wife, just newly married. Then old mother of the son is there, a bit old. This new couple was there for a few days. As soon as the girl comes, the girl was bit very much annoyed and disturbed because she found that the mother-in-law was a nuisance. So normally, as we have got the missionaries today in present world, we can till the land with the tractors or with all the machines. But those days, 2000 years ago, imagine, all this machinery was not there. They have to till their land by their own plows, by their own oxen. So to unite two oxen, this yoke is made. And Jesus was a carpenter's son. So after Joseph's death, Jesus became a very perfect carpenter. And in his shop, it used to be put, my yoke is easy and the burden light. So the caption, we see every shops or anywhere, or the best medicine available possible in the world, it's here in this place. And best treatment is available in this hospital. So we hear all that advertisement. So same way, Jesus also gave this advertisement that in my shop, best yoke is available. And again, so sometimes this oxen will not be the same equal one. One is bigger, the other one is smaller. So these carpenters would know how to make a best yoke. So if it is bigger animal, they will make accordingly that the weight is laid on the bigger animal and the lesser weight is the smaller animal. And that is the work of the perfect carpenter. And Jesus was really a perfect carpenter. So that's how he makes yoke for the oxen. And now, when it comes to the life of every human person, we have heard Jesus telling us, you are much worth than any sparrows. They are neither taken care, the lilies never pour water, but still they flower. They are shining, beautiful, and you are much more worth than all this. If such is the concern that Jesus has for us, can we still feel that our burdensomes are unbearable for us? Definitely not. As real carpenter Jesus could make the yoke easy for the oxen, the same way Jesus makes all our burdensome light ones. Some might feel that I am stressed out, I am worn out, I can't just bear this things that is coming on to me. Just 3 days ago I'm sad to say that a priest committed suicide in India, just 5 years old in his priestly life, committed suicide. It's because of being stressful, because of being worried about so many things, because of worried about his own future, committed suicide. And it is there. Jesus tells us, my burden is easy. I have not given you which you can't bear. I have given you whatever the things that only you can bear. And that is the real concern of Jesus Christ, my dear sisters and brothers. Today, Jesus calls each one of us, whoever is having that heavy heart, come to me. I will give you rest. And my yoke is easier and it is light to bear. Today, let us ask the good Lord that these burdens of all this heavy yoke can be lighter, provided we seek it. Like that the old man went to Jesus every day at noon, 12 o'clock. Jesus, it's Jim. It's me here before you. Can we have such a confidence? Go to him and tell, Jesus, it's me, Raj. Jesus, it's me, John. It's me, Mike. Whatever the... We can just feel free. It's me here. And definitely when we are not able to bear the blunt, the pain, the burden, and he is there at our bed, Jim, it is me, Jesus. Mike, it is me, Jesus. Yes. And that's how we are filled with our happiness. That's how we are filled with the blessings to give happiness to the entire world, as that world man spread their happiness in the hospital ward. Perhaps let that message ring into our own ears. There is a person who calls me with open arms, welcoming me to experience that peace, to experience that light amidst all our burdens. Let us pray that good Lord will give us that yoke which is easier to bear, which is lighter to carry in our life. Amen.
Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God.
Life of God.
brothers, childlike confidence in the Heavenly Father, who has created us in His own image and given us the promise that you are much worth than anything else in the world. The same confidence let us place all our prayers and petitions before the Lord.
And the church and her leaders
may be acceptable and pleasing to God the Almighty Father. May this oblation directed to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our contact closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder. To rule in your name over all you now made and forever praise you in your mighty words. Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray to partake in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring them to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our hope, all our bishops, all the clergy, religious and the faithful gathered here. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her blessed spouse, the Blessed Apostles, St. Philip, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. labor and a burden, I will refresh you, says the Lord. Let us pray. Grant me, pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such a great gift, we may gain the praise of salvation and never cease to praise you through Christ our Lord. May God bless each one of us. Have a wonderful weekend. The Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.